Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. I'm catching up on videos here, so I've got a lot of questions in my inbox. Whenever I get questions, what I typically do if I'm going to make a video out of it now is I will tag it in my Gmail inbox as a question to come back and do a video on. I'm actually planning, I don't know when this video, particular video is going to come out, but I'm planning on doing some HD videos with the good camera setup here, and all the fancy stuff, but that are more topical rather than just answering questions. But I like doing these question ones because I get to do a lot more videos, and it helps me to answer that I typed this long email about. So anyway, this one is more on the real estate side. I promised to do some more kind of real estate investment videos, and I got a question about real estate investment, so I thought, sure, let's do a video about it. It goes like this. Hi, John. I have a quick financial question you might be able to help with. At what point do you decide to purchase rental properties? I currently have all the basics covered: 6 month emergency, contributing to retirement, contributing to kids' college, insurances, etc. The only debt I have is my mortgage, and that would take about 7 years to pay off. I cannot decide if to try to pay off the mortgage, which is less than 4% interest rate, or save $100K to use as a down for a rental. Since you've been doing this for a while, any insight would be appreciated. And this comes from, I believe it's Andre. I'll say Andre. Anyway, so here's the deal with this. You've got mortgage on your house at under 4% interest rate. Well, first of all, before we get into this, good job getting all the debts paid off except for your mortgage. That's great because you really shouldn't be carrying any debt. I mean, aside from a mortgage, right? That's if debt that that a mortgage under 4% is great debt because it's easy to make more than 4% return on your money, right? There's a lot of ways to do that. Not in a bank account, right? But if you're under 4% on your mortgage, that's good. That's a great rate to be at. In the next 10 years, we're not going to see interest rates anywhere close to, we might not ever see them again in the near future like that. So you don't want to pay that off. Stretch that thing out. It might seem a little silly, but you're borrowing money at a very cheap price. Basically, the basic rule, of economics, if you want to get rich, right? This is the basic rule. Like, it's fundamental to any investment, to anything that you do if you want to make money, which is if you can borrow money cheaper than what you can lend it for, or the interest you can make on that money, the return that you can get on that money, you have invented wealth for yourself. You're going to catch the difference in that spread, right? If your mortgage is 4% and you say it's under 4%, and you can find some kind of investment that gives you a 5% interest rate, right? That money that you would have spent to pay off that mortgage, you're making money on, right? You're getting a 1%, right? If you can borrow money from the bank at 4% and then get a 5% return on that money you borrowed from the bank, you're making money, right? And it's not costing you anything. So that's essentially what you're doing when you're keeping the mortgage, because you're making a choice whether or not to take money that you have and put it into a mortgage or not. So I would definitely say that, go ahead and start saving for payment on a rental. It depends on how long it takes you to save up 100K. If it's going to take you a while, like a few years or so, well, first of all, you might not need 100K to buy a rental. Start small. The sooner you buy, the better off you'll be. So maybe you'll buy something smaller where you can put down a 25% down payment or something like that, or 50% down payment. Depends on how risk averse and how much cash flow you want. The more down payment you put in general, like all other things being equal, the higher the cash flow, obviously, but the less leverage you're going to have. There's this little dial I have in real estate, which is basically cash flow or leverage. Cash flow gets you money in your pocket right away every month, less risk. Leverage lets you use the bank's money or someone else's money to potentially make an exponential increase on your money, but high risk, right? And it might cost you money in the short term, money out of your pocket. So you got to kind of decide. Early in my life, I was way on the leverage side, almost to a point of being a little bit foolish on that, right? But now I'm way on the cash flow side because I'm like, now, man, if I just want to retire and do whatever, I need cash flow. So, I would probably, from just what I know of your situation, it sounds like you probably want to be somewhere in the middle. That's going to be a safe, good place to be, you're going to still get, you know, some gains from leverage, and you're going to get some cash flow. You don't want to be in a negative cash flow situation. It's going to stop you from future investments. But, you know, like I was saying, depending on how long it takes you to get that 100K or whatever down payment you need saved up, you may want to take that money and put it somewhere where you're getting some kind of return on it, right? Because you're currently paying, you know, you take the price of what your mortgage is left on your house times 4%, that's what you're paying annually. That's what it's costing you to hold that, right? I mean, you're paying it down, but that's about what you can figure. So you want to be, you know, if you're having like 80K sitting in the bank or so, that's not interest, it could have been paying down your loan and saving you 4%. So it would have been at least earning you 4% on it. So you should be trying to earn more on it while you're waiting. You know, I'm not going to go into the details of the options that you could do, but, you know, at some very basic levels, there's some fairly sound investment strategies using dividend yielding stocks with options, doing selling an option while holding a position that can definitely yield you in the 5% almost guaranteed, you know, or higher. So that's definitely an option. Like I said, you know, if it's going to not take you very long to get enough saved up, then don't even mess around with that. Just go ahead and invest. It's critical that you invest, you know, in real estate as soon as you can. Obviously, prices have been going up, at least here in the U.S. and most of the U.S. Interest rates are probably going to be going up as well. If you can get a loan, now is a good time to do that. So yeah, so that's what I try to start small. Right now, you need to be doing the groundwork, though. If you're thinking about investing, well, you don't want to have 100K burning a hole in your pocket or whatever amount, and then you don't know what to do. So what you want to do is now you want to start trying to get pre-qualified for loans. You want to start talking to real estate agents, getting them to send you listings of investment properties. You want to start running the numbers on those investment properties, crunching the numbers. You need to know the market. It's going to take you about 2 to 3 months of getting listings every day, looking at investment properties before you can just spot identify this is a good deal. And you want to run your numbers very carefully to make sure that it's going to cash flow. Calculate everything involved. You know, you've got a mortgage payment, obviously. You've got insurances. You've got taxes. You might have homeowners association dues. If it's a property you need to, you know, if it's in ill repair, you might have some costs there. There's going to be management fees. You got to calculate all those things out. But yeah, you know, I would say that you're in a great position to invest. The mortgage might make you feel more secure, but it's not going to make you more secure. It's going to make you more secure to make a solid investment in real estate, because it's going to be hard to beat something that's at a 4% interest rate. You know, another way to think about this too is you have an investment property already. That's your house, right? Now, and the reason why I say this is because it costs a certain amount of money for you to live somewhere. You'd either have to rent or you'd have to buy. So, you know, when you own a house, right, or you're paying a mortgage on a house, you're essentially renting to yourself. You are your tenant, and you're a guaranteed tenant who doesn't skip rent and who doesn't and zero vacancy. So it's your best one, right? That's your best investment property that you'll ever buy, because it's the most secure. But you're still paying that out. It's still just like any other investment. So really, you know, the question you should ask is, should you pay off an investment property? No, you're holding it in order to be an investment. Now, I've paid off some of mine move my cash flow balance to where it needs to be. But if you're at the right leverage cash flow situation, you know, which you kind of lock into when you get the loan, then you're going to hold that for the long term. That's the other one last piece of advice I'll give you here. You know, obviously I could talk about this in hundreds of videos, but I will tell you, you're in this for the long haul. Think about this for the long haul. This is a 20-year investment, 30-year investment, you know, 10-year minimum investment, right? This is where the time frame you're thinking. There's no, you know, quick buy and sell. No. You want to find a solid investment that's going to get you good rent, that's going to get you good cash flow. It's going to be a good long term. You have a tenant paying off your mortgage. That's the best situation that you can be in, and you've got a hedge against inflation. So hopefully that helps you. If you like these kind of real estate videos, send me some questions. I'll be happy to answer them. I've got, I've been doing this since I was 18. Yeah, basically since I was 18, I bought my first house. I have, you know, like 26 rental units. I think it's 26 now. Anyway, I'm always in the real estate investment. I've been doing this for a long time. I had my real estate license in Idaho. So yeah, so I'm happy to answer any questions. You know, this is primarily software development, life kind of motivational channel, but hey, this is the kind of thing, you know, I think software developer's life is more than just writing code. And actually, you know, if you want to find out more about this, kind of the whole holistic view that I have, go check out. I just wrote a book that's it's getting close to print at the time of this video. It's in me manning early access. Look for soft skills. Soft skills, the developer's life manual, and it should be out in print December, January. You can get it now early, and you can get early access if you go to Manning and search for soft skills. All right, well, that's it. If you like these videos, have a good time.